Hello, this is a presentation about the multi-ISMI SIM technology, what it means for roaming, and how to easily manage it using the YateHSS HLR. Roaming was traditionally using a single SIM and a single phone number, that is MSISDN, to roam all over the world. This means that whenever you go to a different country, you retain your SIM identity and you also retain your phone number. However, this means that roaming is expensive. When you go into a different country, the operators will ask for more money than in your own country. A business solution for that would be to use an IMSI for a range that is assigned to a national operator of the visited country. So you are apparently not roaming in a different country, and in this case, the prices would be lower for interconnecting and for roaming. That also means that the SIM would have to have multiple identities, and it would have some way of switching between them. In most cases, this switching is done by a Java applet that runs on the card and that would detect either the visited country or would try all the IMSIs available until one of them is accepted during registration. In the home country, of course, we are using the primary IMSI that registers to the HSS HLR, which would assign the primary MSISDN. So, no problem here. Let's go with a different country. Here, we get donor IMSI that is on the same. It tries to register. It manages to register, but in this case, of course, the HSS HLR would need to know that the IMSI is assigned to the same subscriber as before. So, we'll have the same phone number here, that same MSISDN, and we have the same charging, and of course, there'll be a different tax. But, of course, it's much cheaper than roaming directly. When you go to another country, it's possible that the operator in that country will also require you to have an MSISDN matching the visited country. So in this case, not only the SIM identity would change, but it would change also the subscriber's known identity. And again, the HSS HLR would have to know about this and to associate them with the same subscriber. In this case, no matter if you send the phone call or an SMS to the primary MSISDN or any of the others assigned to the same subscriber, the call will be routed to wherever the subscriber is roaming right now, or of course, the SMS in the same way. When the subscriber makes a call, the card has to be routed to the home country, and the MSISDN is rewritten to whatever the others would expect because, of course, they would expect the subscriber to always have his own primary MSISDN. Our platform also allows us to answer to different MSISDN, so we can have several phone numbers that can be called for mobile terminated calls. This can be useful, for example, if you have a convergence between mobile and fixed lines. So you have a fixed number and a mobile number that would both ring the same mobile phone. Let's see how it's done for our product, YateSSS HLR. We have an API that allows for SIM provisioning. The API is called from our mobile management interface, which is web-based interface, through which we can edit details about the subscribers and SIMs, and we can also import SIMs files generated by the SIM vendors. So this is the mobile management interface. We have already one USIM profile entered, and also in the subscriber area, we have already a SIM entered. As you can see, we have a single IMSI to this SIM, but we can edit. We can add an auxiliary IMSI that would be the second one, and we can have a number of additional entities. For example, we take this IMSI here, and we paste it here, but we make some small changes. Let's say this is the network 23, and then we can add another one, and then we put it here. In this case, let's say this is the network 80. But we also want a different phone number here. So, we have 8828-00010. So we save this, and we have seen here an indication that this IMSI is multi-IMSI. We edit again. You see the primary IMSI, the canonical one, the alternate IMSI, and another alternate IMSI, which is also has an MSISDN. We can add some information here which is mostly arbitrary that can be used later to recognize which SIM is which IMSI is which, and which MSISDN is which. So let's say this is network number 1 and this is network number 2, and we save it again. So in this case, we have easily added a different IMSI and MSISDN that would be delivered to whoever is roaming in that country. So by default, the primary IMSI is used. but if the registration comes from this alternate IMSI, it will be handled just as well. And finally, if the registration comes for an IMSI that also has an MSISDN, then the MSISDN will be pushed to the visited network and will act as a public subscriber identity. We can also import SIMs from vendor-provided files. So here we have the provider file that I already imported, and this one is a file that already has two identities. So we asked to test to use the SIM profile test ISM, and we can look here at the content of the file, which contains primary IMSI, which is this one, and the secondary IMSI here, the IMSI number 2. Other parameters are the same, including PIN administrative keys and the authentication vectors. Of course, as you can see here, this is a test SIM. It has pretty easily guessable KI and OPC. So we take that file and we upload it. As we can see, we have uploaded a new SIM that has an auxiliary IMSI already set. It doesn't have multi-IMSI, but we can add more. Let's say we take this one. As you can see, we are using test network 001, and we can add some other identity here, and also MSISDN. Let's say this one is 980011. And this network is 4. And we'll save it. And as you can see, we have the primary IMSI, we have an auxiliary IMSI, and we have also the multi-IMSI, which provides an extra MSISDN in this case. Getting back to the schematic, whenever calls come, our HSS HLR will match any of the sign at MSISDNs, and will send the call to the last IMSI that was registered on the specific technology. So if you go in a visited country on 4G, the request will go to the 4G network using the IMSI that was registered over 4G. If you go in another country again, for example, you may have here roaming in 3G only. And in this case, if you do a call, for example, the call will be directed to the visited country using the IMSI number 3 that was successfully registered from here. It also works if you have multiple IMSI that can register from the same country, but of course the SIM would have an algorithm to use the most efficient one from the financial perspective. Besides that, our HSS HLR would trigger web services that is possible to use, for example, to generate an SMS with OTA message to allow the SIM to change to a more convenient IMSI. That happens if you have a SIM that has already registered but is not the most convenient identity to use. As you can see, our product makes it very easy to manage the complexity of multi-IMSI and MSISDN. And you can just take the SIM files that have been generated by the vendor, possibly with a bunch of IMSIs already attached to it, and you can simply import them, and you have the system working out of the box. Thank you.